Hey, we're back, Big Cat TV. Pastor Andy with Big Cat here. We're having a great day today.
Yeah.
We did a little wardrobe change between this and the last video. So we've been doing some Avenged Sevenfold today, but this is Breaking Benjamin, Ashes of Eden. I promised I won't talk over the guitar solos anymore. We're going to comment at the end.
It's killing them, too.
Like, subscribe. It's brutal. We're making it happen for you guys. Ashes of Eden. Thank you, Ryan Woodcock.
Will the faithful be rewarded when we come to the end? Will I miss the final warning from the lie that I have lived? Is there anybody calling? I can see the soul within, and I am not worthy. I am not worthy of this. Are you with me after all? Why can't I hear you? Are you with me through it all? Then why can't I feel you? Stay with me. Don't let me go. Because there's nothing left at all. The darkness fall upon me when the air is growing thin. Will the light begin to pull me to its everlasting will? I can hear the voices haunting. There is nothing left to fear, and I am still calling. Why can't I feel?
man, you told me this one was gonna be a good one for us to react to. So this is one that I would totally use for like an intro to a Bible study or something like that, because I think so many people out there, based on when people talk with me, they say, well, I'm just not sure if God's real. I've never heard from him. You know, I've prayed before, nothing happens. And so I think this is something that a lot of people can connect with. And, you know, I have a problem as a pastor, as a preacher, because the Bible, when I go to the Bible and say in the scriptures, like, you know, Jesus says things like, my sheep hear my voice, a voice of a stranger they will not follow. In the book of Revelation, he talks about standing at the door and knocking. If anyone opens the door, he'll come and make their home with them. And people may say, well, I've tried, I've prayed, and I just don't hear God. And what do you say to that?
Right.
I mean, that's difficult. You know, but the Bible also says, like, let God be true and every man be a liar.
Yeah.
So I guess one of the questions that I would ask these artists if they're really seeking in this way is, have they turned down, like, if you think of the spirit world as like a radio station, and have you turned off or tuned out all of the other radio stations to actually take some time to listen to God? In other words, are there other voices that you're allowing to continue to enter in? And some people say, in fact, I had a guy tell me this, you know, he said, well, one day I said, God, if you're real, speak to me. And I looked up at the sky for, you know, 10 minutes or whatever, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, nothing happened. Therefore, God is not real. Okay, so, you know, you have those sorts of things, but with anything that you're engaging with, it takes some time. Like, I don't know if anybody's ever played a musical instrument, but I started to play the guitar, and then I started to be able to hear, like, chord changes. Hmm. You know, chord changes when the song changes the chord. I'm not great at it, but I can hear the chord changes, and you start to tune, your ear starts to learn, your brain starts to develop, and you start to be able to hear different things in the music that were there all along. You may have been listening to music your whole life, but you didn't know what you were hearing. You just knew it sounded good or it sounded bad. And that's called, in spiritual terms, that'd be, say, to be able to discern the spirits.
Oh, yeah.
To see which one is from God. And so there's lots of things you can do, which are called spiritual disciplines, to practice that. To practice that, just like you'd practice an instrument or something like that. You say, well, why does God do it that way? Why doesn't he just speak openly to people? Well, one of the reasons is the human race, in the form of the people of Israel, back in the book of Exodus, God spoke directly to the people at that time. And do you know what they told him? They said, speak through this guy Moses. Don't speak directly to us anymore. Something happened there. So there's something about God speaking directly to people. I mean, think about it. If God were to speak directly to you, how do you think that would sound? Yeah, see, for some people, it's like terrifying.
Yeah.
For other people, it's like, well, if you know what the heart of God is, that God actually loves you, that he sent his son so that you wouldn't be condemned, and some of the music that we've reviewed on here, you know, which I think's got it right, that POD song, they've got the grace piece in there. So anyway, if you're not hearing from God, which a lot of people are not hearing from God, what kind of efforts are you making to hear from God? And then recognize, too, like, that it's an impression at times. It's a still, small voice. God speaks through people. He speaks through circumstances. And
donkeys.
And donkeys at times. So you just got to be prepared to hear from him. And then the question is, if you're not going to listen to him anyway, well, that's another thing to think about. And there's a lot of people like that. There's this guy named Jonah that was like that, and he ended up, you know, in the belly of a whale. So thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. This one's a great one. I'm going to use this one again, and I'd be interested to review another Breaking Benjamin song. And we'll see you guys real soon on Big Kitty Cat, because he really is. He's a nice guy. He looks all mean and everything, but he's like a nice guy. But it's Big Cat TV. Don't type in kitty. Just Big Cat TV. Pastor Reacts. We'll see you real soon. Love you guys.